friends. Welcome back to Healthy Grocery Girl and another episode of HGG Home, our DIY design and lifestyle series. In today's video, I'm really excited to share with you our DIY kitchen island project and how we turned this builder grade basic island into one with more warmth and character. So how our DIY projects go is Erin and I work on them together, and typically I start by coming up with a design and some ideas. We discuss them. He usually tells me if that is a realistic idea or not, if it's something he can actually build, and then he is the one that builds the projects and brings them to life. So I wanted a dark, bold color for the kitchen island. However, I tend to gravitate towards neutrals, as you can probably tell from my kitchen, a lot of whites and creams and colors that I feel I'm not going to grow tired of. However, I really wanted a color or something to add more warmth into this space. I was nervous about this color all the way through the entire project, up until the very last paint coat. It was the very last paint coat that really brought it together and made me fall in love with the kitchen island and confirm that it was the right choice to go with a bold color. And I absolutely love it. I hope that you do too. And so Erin's going to share with you our DIY kitchen island project. Oh, one more thing before we get to Erin. All the steps, if you want to create something similar to this, we've written a blog post. So steps and supply list and all of that, there's a link below in the video description box. You can also head to our blog at healthygrocerygirl.com. And if you're not yet following us on Instagram, we share a lot of behind the scenes on our stories of projects and what we eat in the day and things like that. So make sure you're following us on Instagram as well. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, and now let's get started.
This project is the simplest that we've tackled in our kitchen living space, but definitely one I needed to go slow on and make sure all the measurements were as close to exact as possible. Any boards that were short, crooked, or misplaced, even by a small amount, would have stood out. So if you plan to do something similar in your kitchen, I suggest you take your time. The wood that I used were 1x4s and 1x2s, but they were only 1/2 inch thick. I did this because I did not want the board sticking off of the island too much, or it would have looked more like construction framing rather than finished carpentry. I was only able to get these boards in a 3-foot length, so the long run of wood along the bottom is pieced together. To minimize seeing where the two pieces meet, I have made those connections in line with the edge of the vertical boards. Most cuts were simple cross cuts, but it got a little tricky on the ends of the island where I had to do a small jog. In addition, the corners were the most difficult. If I had simply placed two pieces of 1x2 next to each other, one side would have been 1/2 inch thicker than the rest. So I had to trim 1/2 inch from one piece. I used plenty of wall spackle to fill in the gaps and nail holes, and used both medium grit and fine grit sandpaper to achieve a smooth finished look. And now for the fun part, painting. The paint we used is from our favorite brand, Ecos Paints. We went with their eggshell paint, which has a medium sheen and dries to a really nice hard finish. Ecos recommends this for kitchens, bathrooms, and other high moisture areas. And with two youngsters, it is great to have a really highly washable paint on the kitchen island. For the color, Megan chose a Sherwin-Williams color called Tricorn Black, and we had Ecos Paints color match that. As we painted the island, we were honestly a little hesitant about such a dark color, but once it was finished and the third coat had dried, we were very happy with the finished look. Here it is again, before and after.
It turned out amazing, right? I absolutely love it. It did exactly what I was hoping by adding character and warmth into our kitchen. And again, I'm always so impressed with Aaron's building skills. Like, he just knows how to do all of this, which to me, like, I can visualize ideas and come up with ideas, but to then figure out how to actually build them and bring them to life, like, that is on Aaron, and he does such a good job. And so thank you, Aaron, for another amazing DIY home project. And again, if you want to make something similar to this, Aaron has written a blog post with sharing more of the steps, the supply list, and things like that. And then if you have questions for him on this project, just leave them below in the comment section and we will do our best to answer all of your questions. So thank you again so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up so we know that you like these types of videos and we'll keep making more. And follow us on Instagram @HealthyGroceryGirl. I hope that you have a wonderful day and we will see you in the next video. Bye.